The time has come. The moment has arrived. With thousands and millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, strap yourself into your seats. Welcome to the Johnny Ward Radio Show.
You understand me, boy? You understand me, boy? I am not a boy. I am a very, very strong man. And I have told you that before. Take this.
Ooh! Very, very hard to learn the English language. I'm Bill. So dumb.
Get a book, you twit. To the left. To the right. Forward march. Bloody listen to me, you twerp.
Ooh, it's so scary in here. The lights have gone out.
I just don't know why I came to London. You people here, you're not right. There's something wrong with you. Why are they making airplane seats so skinny?
To get more bloody money, you fool!
That's it, money!
Oh, I love Dabba. I love their songs, you know.
I'm going to ask you for the last time.
Did you kill Mrs. Davidson?
No, I didn't! No! You idiot!
The planets are getting closer. The moon, the sun, they're getting closer.
I don't know what the hell is going on here. Are you talking to me? Are you talking to me?
Do you know, I would love to make an omelette and just throw it right up in the air and hopefully it'll get stuck to the ceiling and as the wife walks in, it'll right on the bunk.
That's not a very nice thing to do, you know, to your wife.
Well, you don't know my wife, do you?
Click kicks for anyone!
Ladies and gentlemen, here he is! Here's Johnny! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Johnny Ward Radio Show. Whoa, what a week it's been. We have got some great guests here on the Johnny Ward Radio Show. We really have today. I hope you're all good. And my first guest, ladies and gentlemen, is from Boxing World, the great John Fury, who I know is very busy this week.
Thanks very much, John. Thank you very much.
John, thank you very much for coming into the studios in the Ritz Hotel down in Mayfair in London.
It's a pleasure, John. You know I love coming up here and speaking to you.
Now, John, there's a lot been going on this week. Are you happy about it?
No, John, I'm not. I'm not happy at all.
What's happening? Because your son's fighting. Tommy Fury is fighting in Manchester this Saturday.
That's right, John. He's fighting KSI, and they're what's he called? YouTubers. Now, what the hell is me son doing fighting YouTubers?
Well, you must have told him about it.
I know that, John. I've told him, but they've got plenty of mouth. And today, I nearly knocked one of them out, this KSI. I've had enough of it, John. I've had it.
John, look, why don't you just calm
down? No, I won't calm down, John. I've had enough of it. I've had enough of Tommy, me son, and I've had enough of Tyson. Every time they're going to have fights, they get called off. That's no good to me. In the old days, you got up, you took your top off, and you had a fight.
And so what are you going to do then? Because Tommy was in Love Island.
I know he was in Love Island. I know that, John. You don't have to tell me that. But I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to fight. I've told Tommy that he won't be fighting on Saturday. I want to fight this guy. KSI instead.
But you can't do that, John. You're six.
Don't mention my... John, please. You shouldn't say that. I'm going to fight this guy on Saturday, and I'm going to beat him. And I'll tell you what, I fell out with Tyson as well, my son. I've really fed up with him.
What's the matter with
him? He keeps saying he's going to fight this fighter, he's going to fight that fighter, and it never happened, and I'm fed up with it. I will fight them all, John. I will fight them all. I tell you what, instead of, I've told Tyson, I will fight Wilder, Uskov, and Joshua, and I will beat the three of them, John.
Well, John, you know, I can see, you know, you're really up for it. And,
John, I am up for it. I'm the father of these boys, and they're not taking it seriously. They keep saying they're going to fight and then they don't. I will be fighting. So Manchester, turn your tellies on Saturday. I will be fighting on Saturday.
Ladies and gentlemen, the great John Fury. Thank you, John. Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure, John. Always a pleasure to be here.
Cool. I'm going to watch that on Saturday with John Fury. Cool. He's in a right mood, isn't he? You know, but very nice of him to come up. Ladies and gentlemen, line one, who is it?
Hello. Hello. Is that Johnny?
Hello. Who's that?
It's Sir William Bunker.
Hello, Sir William, and how are you?
I'm fine, Johnny. I thought I'd give you a ring. I do apologise. Last week I was in the Kremlin last week.
That's right. You was in the Kremlin with a Putin, and you'd had drinks with him all. And where are you now? You're back in England?
Well, no, John. I'm in Thailand at the moment.
Thailand, Sir William. You really do get about a bit, don't you?
Well, yes, yeah. I mean, I'm.
Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. I'm fine. As you know, I'm the UK representative of alcohol distribution all around the world.
Yes, I do know that, John. Is that what you're doing out in Thailand?
Well, yes, I'm trying to. I'm having a holiday as well. I'm trying to sell some alcoholic beverages. I'm in a place at the moment in Thailand called the Thailand Basket.
Oh, the Thailand Basket. And what is that, a bar or something?
Yes, it's
You okay?
Yep. I'm fine, John. I'm fine, John. Obviously, you know, I have to have drinks myself to represent the country.
Well, I know that, yes, you know.
I've had quite a few drinks today. But I'm mixing I'm mixing my work for the government, selling the alcohol abroad. I'm having a holiday also myself while I'm over here.
Oh, that's good. So you're mixing the two together. Are you with your wife at all?
No, Johnny. I'm.
Oh, you're not married.
Well, I know. I know you've not asked me this before, but I might. Sir William Bunker. I was married four times.
Four times?
Yes. Four times. All lovely ladies. But it didn't work out in the end. And I had 16 children.
16 children?
Yeah, I've got 36 grandchildren.
My God, I've never known anything like that. And how old are you now, Sir William?
I'm 78 now. And I'm with my girlfriend here, a beautiful girl, Titia.
Titia? Oh, that's a nice name, isn't it? Oh, is she like your age group or anything? 78?
No, Titia's 22.
22? Oh, and have you been with her a long time?
Well, whenever I come over to Thailand in the Thailand basket, I go in there. And well, you got to be careful. I'm not being horrible. I'm just trying to give you a bit of advice. No, John, I do take advice.
You know, I'd like to give you some advice. In summer, is there a lot of these girls in there? Are they same as Titia?
Oh, there's 20, 30 girls in there, all look like Titia.
Well, Sir William, be careful, because some of them are ladyboys.
Ladyboys? Oh, no. I don't get involved in anything like that.
Well, you've not been involved in it.
Oh, no, John. No, Titia is a beautiful girl. And we go. But I thought I'd give you a call anyway, John.
And are you doing business over there?
Yes. So the business is going well. I've some beautiful Scottish whiskey. The whiskey always goes well in Thailand. And, Johnny, I'll give you a call next week, and hopefully we can get together back in London. Maybe I could introduce us to Titia.
Well, that would be very nice, you know.
Maybe I could bring her up the studio.
Well, no, not at the moment. I will let you know about that.
Well, okay, John. Anyway, I've got to sign off now, John. Sir William Bunker, UK representative of alcohol distribution around the world.
Thank you very much, Sir William Bunker. What a man he is. He really is a nice man. I really like him. Ladies and gentlemen, I always love this. This is Scottish People, ladies and gentlemen. We look at Scottish people every week. And this week, ladies and gentlemen, we've got another singer. Yes, I know, we always have a few Scottish singers on the show, called Wee Alec McBain. Ah! Alec, thank you very much for coming into the studios here for Scottish People.
Oh, that's fine, Johnny. Thank you. I appreciate that.
And Alex, you've worked many years as a singer.
Oh, yes, John. Very, very many years as a singer up in the Highlands in Scotland. And what part of Scotland do you come from, Alex?
Oh, I come from a place called the Mall of Galloway.
Oh, yes, that's very up, right up high in Sweden.
Oh, yes, yes. Yes, that's right up here, right up here.
And have you been a singer for most of your life?
Oh, yes, I've been a singer for most of my life. And I do like singing the songs that, you know, I was brought up with my family many years ago in Scotland.
Well, thank you very much, Alex, for coming along. I've got to say, the Johnny Wall Radio Show love Scottish People each week. They really do. Alex, I'm so looking forward to singing one of your songs. And what song would it be?
It's called "I Love a Lassie."
Oh, it's, yes, I've heard that song.
It's a song that my father used to sing to me and all the other family members.
Thank you very much, Alex. And if I could just tee you in, 3, 2, 1.
I love a lassie, a bonnie hearing lassie. If you see her here, you would fancy her. I met her in September, popped a question in November, so I'll soon be having her to my mace. Her father has contented, so I'm feeling quite contented, cause I've been and sealed the bargain with a kiss. I sit and weary, weary when I think about my dearie, and you'll always hear me singing this. Oh, I love a lassie, a bonnie, bonnie lassie. She's as pure as the fly in the dell. She's as sweet as the heather, the bonnie, bonnie heather, my Scottish girl.
Oh, that's fantastic. Absolutely fantastic, Alec. That really is. And I can tell that you are a very, very accomplished singer.
Oh, yes, Johnny. I've been singing, like I say, for many, many years. The McBean family all sing.
Well, I know you've got to go now because you're singing tonight back in Scotland. Don't you?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. And would you like me to sing the chorus again?
Oh, I don't know about that. Sorry, what did you say? Nothing. Yes, I'd love to sing the chorus again. That would be fantastic. Ready? I'll feed you in. 3, 2, 1.
I love a lassie, a bonnie, bonnie lassie. I could sit and tease me here for a week. For the way she keeps behaving, will I never pay her calls? Cause she rubs the whiskers clean off my chin. And the standard bonnet, where is the hair that nuns on it goes? For she pats me on the head. All together now. I love a lassie, a bonnie, bonnie lassie, and she's pure as the heather in the dell. She's as sweet as the heather, my bonnie, bonnie heather, me my Scotch bluebell.
Fantastic, fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, please give him a big round of applause. Alec McBain on Scottish People. Thank you, Alec.
Thank you, Donnie.
Yeah, it's pretty clear, I ain't no size 2, but I can shake it, like I'm supposed to do, cause I got that boom boom that all the boys chase, and all the right junk in all the right places. I see the magazine working that Photoshop, we know that shit ain't real, come on now make it stop. If you got beauty, just raise them up, perfect from the bottom to the top.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a great coup on the show, the Johnny Wald Show, and it's called Happy Harry, and it's a celebration of Harry Kane, who left Spurs not long ago and he's gone to Bayern Munich, and Harry is absolutely enjoying it there. So Harry is here with one of the owners of the club, Dr. Drestich, and I'd like to thank the two of you for coming to the Johnny Wall Radio Show, the studios here in Mayfair. And this is about a celebration, really, of Harry doing so well and what would happen if he didn't do so well. So first of all, Harry, I'd like to say thank you very much.
It's fantastic to be here. It's fantastic to be at Bayern Munich Club. I've come here with Dr. Drestich today, and just to talk about the club and what would happen if things didn't go well for me, you know, things like that.
Well, Dr. Drestich, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you for inviting me to come on the show.
And obviously, Harry's been doing very well.
Harry's been doing fantastic well at the moment. He's scoring goals. But as you all know,
forwards and certain players do go off, and sometimes they do not score for long periods of time.
Well, there's no need to shout.
I'm not shouting. It's just the way I talk.
Okay, I accept that. And what do you mean by all this?
Well, we do not allow things like that to happen.
I mean, obviously, Dr. Drastic, I will be trying my hardest.
I know that, Harry. I know you will try your hardest. Even the best players in the world who played for this club go down the drain sometimes. If we do not allow that, we have to, in certain ways, try to get you back playing to the best of your ability.
Obviously, I know that, and the goals I'm scoring at the moment, I feel quite scared, actually, the way you're talking to me, as if, you know, it's like if I don't score goals in three or four games, something might happen to me. I might disappear or something, or I might...
Don't be stupid. That will never happen. It is just the way I was brought up, in this sort of manner to be quite aggressive. But I'm quite a nice person, if you get to know me.
Well, look, that's very nice of you, Dr. Drastic, to come here, but you really are a wild man, aren't you?
I'm not a wild man. I just speak my mind. There's nothing wrong to do that. If Harry, after we paid 150 million for him, does not perform to a certain level, there will be implications to take care of.
Obviously, I will play good all the games. I will never have a bad game, hopefully, and otherwise I can see certain things happening which will not be good for me. Well, I'd like to say, Harry, while you're over here in England, I would stay here if I was you, because if you don't score, obviously there's going to be trouble over there.
But I must say before we go, Johnny, thank you for inviting us here. If you would like to come out for dinner with us, come have a dinner with you. You wouldn't stop shouting at everyone if your food was cold. No.
And all I can say is thank you very much for coming to the studio, Dr. Drastic. And Harry, I wish you the best of luck. Ladies and gentlemen, happy Harry, who's having a great time over in Bayern Munich, Germany. Thank you, Harry. Thank you very much.
Hello, Malcolm. How are you? Ladies and gentlemen, this is our cleaner here in the studios in the Ritz Hotel for the Johnny Wald Radio Show. How are you? How are you doing, Malcolm?
I'm all right, Johnny. Yeah, I'm all right.
Have you had a good weekend?
Yeah, I love it. Yeah. I've popped down to see you.
Well, I've got a very busy show, Malcolm.
No, Johnny, you'll be interested in this. You know, last week, Beckham, he doing his film, wasn't he, in the West End?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, called Beckham. He was in the studios.
Yeah, I heard him. Well, he stayed in the Ritz Hotel, in this hotel.
Oh, I didn't realise that.
Yeah, well, what's happened, John? You know, I'll go around and I'll clean the rooms. Well, I've noticed that in his room, I went in there and they said he'd gone. Whatever's left, you can keep. Well, I've got some lovely suits, what he's left here. He's got a lovely Ted Baker suit there.
Oh, is it a 36 waist?
Yeah, it's a 36 waist.
Well, oh, I'll have that one.
Oh, yeah, I'll bring it down. You can buy it off me. I'm not giving it to you.
And anything else left there?
Oh, yeah, his wife, Victoria, you know, the one that's... I think he's took her to hospital, John.
Oh, nothing serious.
Yeah, no, I think she's got to have an operation to make her smile.
Oh, yeah, that's not very nice to say that, Malcolm.
I'm only joking. But anyway, there's lots of her dresses been left there and that, so I don't know what size your wife is.
She's very slim.
Well, I'll bring them down. Do you use a man bag, John?
Oh, yes, I like them bags.
You know, you can carry all your bits and bobs in them.
Yeah, I'll definitely have that.
There's a man bag, there's a clutch bag, and there's a Kit Kat. And also some, do you like Greg's steak bakes?
Oh, I love Greg's steak. What do you mean Beckham and his wife was eating steak bakes?
Well, they must have ordered them, John.
But that's fantastic. Listen, keep this between me and you, because you're not nicking them, are you?
Well, no, they've been left there. So if they've left there and I'm cleaning the room, John, they're mine. But I'll sell them to you.
How much do you want for it?
Well, we'll sort that out when I say... Oh, also... Oh, I don't know if you should keep this quiet. There was a black wig there, a man's one.
Oh, so
You're saying that David Beckham's bald. Well, yeah, otherwise if it was a woman's one, it would have been a long one, wouldn't it? You know, a big long one. Well, Malcolm, yes, if you could get them clothes down, Malcolm, I'd really appreciate that. Thank you very much, John. I've got to go. Ladies and gentlemen, that's Malcolm. Malcolm is the cleaner at the Ritz Hotel. Also cleans my studios here in the Ritz Hotel. Thank you, Malcolm. Thanks, Johnny. Line three, who is it?
Hello, John. It's David the activist.
Oh, hello, David. How are you? Hope things are going well this week. You know, after the tree and all that, you know, the tree that you cut.
Oh, I don't talk about that, John. You know, and what I want to tell you, John, did you see me on the telly last night?
No, on the telly? What was you doing on there?
I was the one that ran up on stage and put all that glitter on Keir Starmer.
Oh, was it you, David? I've never seen you before. Oh, that was you. But you said your name was Ellie Woofie or something.
No, I just made that up. It's me, David the activist. I've done it for a bit, John. Someone said, I'll give you 100 quid, you go and pull all glitter over him and shout out, I want an ass. And I did.
Well, I heard that, yeah. But all the coppers go,
how they bundled me off, John. But after I said it was only a joke and that, they let me go. And they only let me back in the bloody banquet there where they was.
No, they let you back. And did you see Keir Starmer and apologise?
Well, yeah, I went over to it. I was all calling him Glitterhead.
Oh, dear. And what happened when he saw you?
He said, you want a drink? And I ended up having a drink with him all night long. He had his arms around me. We was doing the okey-cokey. And, oh, it was really good.
Oh, that's unbelievable, isn't it? Yeah, well, David, look, I hope you're keeping out of trouble. You're lucky you didn't go back to prison.
Well, they didn't know my real name, John. You, like I said, you've only got to change one middle name, and you can get anything in this life.
Well, David, you're a very crafty git, but I can't believe that it's you. Now I know what you look like, David. The police will know who you look like now.
No, they won't, John. You know, I'm still nicking all the bloody Eulers, like cameras and all that. Like.
Right, David, I'm going to come off now. David the activist, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Thanks, John. I'll bring you soon.
Ladies and gentlemen, next on our show for football legends this week, it's the great, great Jeff Stelling, formerly from Sky Sports. Thank you, Jeff, for coming on the show.
Things are going well. I think they're going as well as I could do. Good to get away from Merson and all the rest of them. Been with him for 25 years. I knew I was going to get the sack at some stage. So I took, John, redundancy.
Clever thing to do, Jeff.
Well, I've got enough money now to do what I want, John. Yes, yes, yes.
And what about,
no, my wife is playing up. My wife I've been with for many, 25, 30 years, said to me, John, she said, I've got to say to you, I'm going to leave you. You're totally obsessed with football. We've been together for over 13 seasons.
That's a good one, Jeff.
No, it's not a joke. She did leave me. And my second wife said, look, it's either me or football. And I said, could you give me 90 minutes to think about it?
But you've had some great times on the show, Jeff. Just give me the...
Well, let me tell you about this one. I think it was Arsenal versus Tottenham at Highbury. I heard goal. And I went, Charlie Nicholas at... Highbury, what's happened? And Charlie said, you won't believe what's happened, Jeff. You won't believe what's happened. The referee's Phil flattened his fist in the mud. And Arteta has then run on the pitch, picked up the ball, run the whole length of the pitch, volleyed it in the back of the net. The referee's then got up, saw the ball in the back of the net, and gave the goal to Arsenal. The score, Arsenal 1, Spurs 0. They went absolutely berserk, John. And then I heard another goal! And I shouted, it looks like Liverpool over to Tomo. Tomo, who scored?
No goal, Jeff. No goal.
But you just said goal.
No, Jeff. I said, oh, because someone trod on my foot, Jeff. If it had been a goal, I would have gone, goal. But it was all.
So that was that. And then we went over to see Cammy. Cammy, what's the score with Burnley versus Huddersfield? What's the score, Cammy?
I'm not at the football, Jeff.
Where are you?
I'm in the kitchen. I've got my underpants on and I'm making some toast.
Well, that's it, ladies and gentlemen. We'll come back in 5 minutes after we've sorted out Cammy. John, I've got to go now. I'm working for TalkSport now, and it looks like if I don't get back in the next 2 or 3 minutes, I could get the sack. That's for me, Jeff Stelling, today live on the Johnny Ward
Radio Show. Thanks very much, Jeff. Very nice of you for coming in. Jeff Stelling, ladies and gentlemen. Jeff Stelling. Thank you, Jeff. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed the Johnny Wolf Radio Show. That's it, ladies and gentlemen. Hey, hey, till next week. So I really hope you enjoyed the show. Please keep listening. And from now, this show will go over to Twitter. And from there, you will get a link onto YouTube. So please keep looking at it. And please enjoy the show. Have a great week yourself. Thank you very much. And as I always say, shut up your face. What's the matter, you? Got no respect. What do you think you do? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad. It's a nicer place. Shut up your face. That's a great. What's the matter, you? Got no respect. What do you think you do? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad. It's a nicer place. Shut up your face. Okay, one time for mama, everybody. What's the matter, you? Got no respect. What do you think you do? Why you look so sad? It's a not so bad.